Namaste, I am Dr. S. Sachidanand, Vice Chancellor, Rajagopalan University of Health Sciences, Bangalore. As all of you are aware, we are in the midst of coronavirus epidemic, or can I say a pandemic. More than 185 countries across the globe is now affected with this coronavirus or COVID-19 disease. What should we do as a public or as an individual? What is my role in this situation? First of all, we need not panic. There's nothing to be worried about. This is like any other common flu that afflicts the mankind. But of course, it has got large spreadability. Very easily, it is contagious. And that's the reason why we have to be worried about. Whereas the mortality rate by this disease is very less. If we can take precautions, adequate precautions, and see that the disease doesn't spread, we are doing a lot of good to the society and also to the humanity. All you need to do is do not panic. Do not believe in rumors that are spread by rumor mongers. Always seek for authentic information from authentic websites, like websites from WHO or Government of India or Government of Karnataka or even Health Department for that matter. So authentic information, first of all, you be well informed. If you are well informed, I'm sure all of you will be able to fight the disease in a better manner, one. And there are some do's and don'ts that you need to follow at this point of time. First of all, follow social distancing. This is only to keep yourself healthy and fit. If you are fit and if you are healthy, you also can render your service to the society at the hour of need. So first of all, keep maintaining social distance. Keep away from anybody, whether you are dear and near ones, your child, your pet, your relatives, your friends. So all of them, at least from a meter away, so that when you speak to each other, the droplets from your mouth and droplets from the person's mouth does not get exchanged, or you don't inhale that. That is not, that will prevent the spread of the disease, one. Number two, whenever there's a person whom you come across who is coughing or sneezing or has fever, kindly refer them to fever clinics which has already been established. In case you develop these symptoms, don't hesitate to go and get a checkup done. And then the system takes care of your health from then on. But at the same time, if you feel that somebody else has got all these symptoms and they're not exposing themselves to the treatment or even for surveillance, coming under surveillance and then getting treatment, please inform the authorities so that they will be immediately checked. Because even one single person having the symptoms and signs can spread it to so many others in a due course of time. That is why we have to prevent the spread of the infection at this point in time. Simple other ways of not acquiring the disease is by wearing a mask. When you wear a mask, that droplets do not travel further away. It gets filtered in the mask, and then the spread of the infection also is minimized. So everybody should wear mask at this point of time when they're moving around. First of all, movement has to be completely restricted. You have to stay at home and be healthy. But in case you need to go out and meet people for whatever reasons, always wear a mask. That will prevent a lot. Third thing is within your own premises. Most importantly, the virus which comes out of a human who is infected can, be present on the items that the person comes in contact with, like a table, maybe utensils, maybe remote, mobile, keychains, doorknobs. These are the things which we always keep touching. And once we touch, if those surfaces are infected by the virus, your hands will carry the virus. Now, how to get rid of this virus from your hands? It's very simple. Just by washing your hands frequently with good soap and water and good lather will remove the virus completely. Or even sanitizers with 70% alcohol is also good enough to kill the virus instantly. So when these viruses are killed on your hands, the chances of the virus spread to you is also minimized. And third importantly, even if the hands are very contaminated and you have virus on your hands, even though you're washing your hands frequently, do not touch the face, do not touch the eyes, nose and mouth, and that will prevent the infection from spreading. That is the most important thing. So these three simple steps, maintaining social distance, wearing mask and washing your hands, not touching your face, will itself prevent the spread of the disease. It will break the chain. That is most important. And fourthly, you have to maintain your health at this point of time. Eat good food, eat well balanced diet. And also eat food with a lot of vitamin C, like lemon and amla and other things, which will improve your immunity. always have positive thoughts in your mind, because if you have positive thoughts, the immunity also will be in a good state of mind, good state of functioning. So that is what is important. So if you maintain all these things as volunteers, as per general public, as people working in NGOs, as people who are ready to help and shoulder the responsibility to combat this disease, you all of you will be healthy and fit. I request all of you to follow these guidelines so that whenever there's a call for either from the health department or from the government or from Government of India or from any authority who requires your service, please be ready and try to volunteer. The areas where you can help us, you can do help them in doing active surveillance, quarantining the patients, doing a good health education to people about the disease, and also teaching them and telling them how to break the chain of spread of the disease. So all these are important things which you can do whenever they're required. Plus, the frontline workers like doctors, nurses, and paramedical staff who are working day and night in the hospitals, and also expecting worsening of the state, all these preparations that are being done by the Department of Health and Family Welfare and Medical Education, Government of Karnataka and Government of India, by stocking the required personal protection, protective equipments, ventilators, drugs, and isolation beds, and all these things are being done by government, so that in case of an eventuality, your services may also be required. Please volunteer. I request all of you to register in the numbers that is given by the department. Kindly call up and register yourself, and then be available. Like any soldier who is required to fight any war at the point of emergency. So now we are going through this phase. I request all of you to be ready and always be available. Thank you so much.